In this video, I'm going to cover 5 ways on how you can use ChatGPT for your real estate listings. Katie Lance here, and I'm so excited to talk about ChatGPT. ChatGPT is taking the world by storm, and as of the recording of this video, it is absolutely free, and it is an awesome tool for real estate professionals to use specifically for real estate listings. So if you have a new listing, or maybe you've got a listing that you need to freshen up in terms of your marketing, stay tuned. I'm going to share 5 of my favorite tips and ideas that you can use to implement into your real estate marketing right away. Let's go. Number 1, property descriptions. So I know for a lot of you, writing a property description can feel a little bit laborious. It can feel a little bit like a grind. And so I absolutely love ChatGPT for this. What you can do is open up ChatGPT and you want to write a simple prompt. So you can write something like, write a property description for a new property that I have, 123 Main Street in any town, USA. This new property has, and this is where you want to include some details. So you can say this property is a 4-bedroom, 2-bath, approximately 2,000 square feet, has a gourmet kitchen, granite countertops, a newer roof, it backs to open space, it's in a great location. Okay, so we give it just enough information to create a compelling property description. I like to kind of put in maybe 5 to 8 points about that listing, right? Within a matter of seconds, you're gonna see a property description come back to you. Now, as I always say, don't just copy and paste blindly. We wanna read it carefully, and here's where you can add in your 2 cents, your personality, and add in additional details. From here, you can also say add in additional bullet points, right? So the property description might just be a few paragraphs. If you wanna add in additional bullet points, you can ask for that as well. Huge time saver. This is also really helpful if you are rewriting a listing description. You know, maybe you are taking on a property that was previously with another agent. So you can say, I'm going to give you a lot of copy for a previous property description. Take this and rewrite it. So you can copy an older description and ChatGPT will rewrite it, which is awesome. But again, proofread it, add your 2 cents. Don't just copy and paste without reading it. Super important. Okay, number 2, social media posts. So once you've taken that property description, now you can say in the next thread of that conversation, because as ChatGPT works, you're gonna ask a question, you're gonna get an answer. And as you keep asking questions, it's a nice long thread, all based on the same topic, right? So I like to start with asking for the property description. And then the next thing I would ask is, okay, based on this property description, please write for me 3 to 5 social media posts that I can use for Facebook, Instagram, or LinkedIn, right? Or whatever platforms that you're on. Now you can even ask as well, you can say, hey, in addition to the social media posts, add emojis, add relevant hashtags, and add a compelling call to action, which I love. So then it's gonna come back to you with some really great social media posts, which again, you could tweak, you can rework, you could say, hey, rewrite the second one or rewrite the third one, whatever you'd like, or you can keep them the same. Now, as an aside, one extra thing you could do is once you've gotten those social media posts, you could say, write these again, but in a storytelling format. Right, in a storytelling format. And I've had ChatGPT do this before. It's really fun and creative. It'll usually come back to you with some sort of once upon a time or some sort of storytelling format, which again gives you additional options for social media. It also gives you some options for some video content, which we'll get to in just a second. By the way, if you find this video helpful so far, we would absolutely love if you'd hit the subscribe button and the bell button because we have new videos that come out each and every week. All right, let's get on with the show. Number 3, Reels and TikTok ideas. So again, you've got this running list in ChatGPT. You've asked for the property description, you've asked for social media posts, you've asked for possible storytelling ideas, and the next thing you could say is now write 5 Instagram Reels and or TikTok ideas based on this property description, right? And you can ask for as many as you'd like. I usually ask for like 3 to 5. It'll come back to you with 3 to 5 ideas, which again, you can tweak. You can say, you know what? I don't really like number 2. Can you replace that with a different one? Or if you like it, great. You could even say, okay, great. Based on those 5, now give me 5 video scripts I could use with those 5 ideas. So now you've got the property description, you've got social media posts, and even some story ideas, you've got some video ideas and scripts. Number four, YouTube descriptions. If you're doing a video property tour, maybe you have a professional you're working with that's doing a video property tour, or you're doing it yourself, and if you're putting it on YouTube, which I definitely recommend, YouTube is the number two search engine in the world. It's owned by Google, and so any type of video content, I highly recommend that you also put it on YouTube. One of the biggest mistakes a lot of agents and brokers make with YouTube is they don't really have a description, or if there's anything there, it's very minimal. So what I would recommend is, again, in ChatGPT, you've got sort of this running thread of conversation. You've asked for the property description, the social media posts, the video ideas, and now you can say, write me a YouTube description that is SEO-friendly, search engine optimized friendly, also include YouTube keywords. Right, so now it's gonna take that content and it's going to rewrite it into a description that you can put into a description on YouTube, which is going to include the description, some relevant keywords, again, perhaps a compelling call to action. And now if you've got that video, you can upload it to YouTube and you've got your description ready to go. You could also say, in addition, write me 3 to 5 ideas for a YouTube title. Titles and descriptions are key. The video is one thing, but having the right title and descriptions are key. So you could also ask for in that thread, hey, please also write 3 to 5 compelling YouTube ideas for the title of this video. Idea number 5, blog posts or email newsletters. I know there's a lot of folks who work with us inside of our Get Social Smart Academy who take their property descriptions and their listings and they also want to display them on their websites. So if that's you, if you're creating a blog post for each listing, or maybe you're doing some sort of blogging when it comes to your listings, and again, if you feel like, gosh, that's just a big time suck, even if you like to write, I find it is helpful to get a little bit of help from ChatGPT. So again, you go back into your ChatGPT and now you can say, write me a blog post that I could put on my blog that goes with this property. Or you could say, write me an email newsletter that could go with this property. So you'll see that same content turn into either a blog post or an email newsletter that you can use and send out to your database. So many great ideas that I absolutely love. And what I recommend too is once you've created all that content, you can let it live in ChatGPT, but remember, it's free. And every once in a while, ChatGPT is a little buggy and sometimes those conversations appear or disappear, which means after you've gotten all your content ideas, I really recommend that you copy and paste all of those ideas and put them into a Google document or a Word document or somewhere where you can easily access them so you're not always just going back to ChatGPT. But so many opportunities for ChatGPT, especially for properties, especially for real estate listings. Okay, I would love to hear from you. What was your favorite idea that we talked about today? And are you using ChatGPT, yes or no? Let me know in the comments below. And of course, if you enjoyed these videos, we would absolutely love if you'd hit the subscribe button and the bell button, as we have new videos that come out each and every week. And last but not least, if you want to really take your expertise with ChatGPT to the next level, we would love for you to download our free ChatGPT for Real Estate Guide. Go to katielance.com/ChatGPT and download our free checklist. I know you're gonna absolutely love it. All right, I can't wait to see what you create. We'll see you soon. Bye for now.